Hello everybody and welcome back to this tutorial. And right now what we are going to do is we are going to take a look at the import function in Python 3. Now, importing modules is very important because it allows us to import different Python programs into our own program, which allows us then to use different function methods from that specific program. Now, we didn't cover functions yet, but basically, a function is everything that performs something. So, for example, the print is a function, the input is a function. We will cover and code our own functions later on. But for now, let's see how we can use those functions from different libraries that the Python 3 gives us. So, open up your actual, open up your idle right here. And in order to import some library that you need, such as basically all of your real actual programs will need some libraries. For example, the OS library, the sys library, subprocess library, socket library for networking, and so on and so on. In order to import any of those, you can just type here import. And then afterwards space and then the name of the library itself. So let's, for example, import first the OS library. Now, the libraries are most likely always going to be imported at the beginning of the program, right at the top. So you import all the libraries you need, and then you perform your own code down below. Now, let's see some of the actual functions that we can actually get from this OS library. So, for example, in order to access a function from this specific library, you need to specify first the name of the library itself. So in our case, that is the OS, so just type OS, then dot, and then you specify the name of the function. So you can see right here, let me just go right here. Right here, by default, the Python interpreter will give you the name of all the functions that the OS library has, so you don't actually have to remember them, but right now what we are searching for is the system library. Well, pardon me, the system function. What this function will allow us to do is to actually, for example, create files, delete files, and do anything, or basically send any command to our system. So, for example, let's execute a command cd. If you just type here enter, let me just put that into an actual, you can't really do that, but you can do something like this. I mistook this library with the subprocess library, which I will show you just in a second. If you just go right here, new folder, create it, call it test, and try to perform the os.remove and then the name of the folder itself. So if you just specify between the single quotes test and press here enter, the system cannot find the specified file test. Okay, maybe, yeah, of course, because this is not really in the actual path that the actual folder is. So just go right here onto the new file, import os, and then use os.remove and then between the single quotes type test. Save this on to the desktop or save it to the same folder where your test directory is. So save, I want to save it right here as the remove.py. Save it, we can see that our program, let me just find it. Where is our remove.py? Okay, so here it is. If we run it, run module, access is denied for test. For some reason, we get access is denied, but never mind. We can just, let me just try it like this. For some reason, we get access is denied, but it doesn't even matter. Let me just check out what happens if I just use system and then, for example, dir in between. Will it list it right here? Yeah, probably not. It will only execute it, doesn't even matter. We will check the output with the subprocess library. What matters is that we can actually create the directory with it. So let me just go right here, save as once again. But not this program, we want to create a new one. And we want to do the same thing that we did, just into a different directory. So import OS and then file save as. Well, let's just try to create an actual directory. So we'll use os.system, even though this is not how you should create files. We can try to do it, mkdir test. We save it right here, which is in the app data local Python 37. So right here should be the test should be actually saved. So let me just save it right here. Let's call it again remove.py because it is not in the same directory. We can call it like that. And I will run it from my command prompt. So cd app data, cd roaming, cd programs. Or was it programs? Cd local, maybe there. Cd programs, cd python, and change directory to Python 37. If I just type here, dir right here, we have the remove.py. So if I just type python.exe remove.py and just type dir once again, we have the test directory created, as you can see right here. So we have the test directory. Let us just check if we can go from here. Yeah, it is right here. Test directory has been created. Of course, it is empty. So we successfully created the directory with our remove.py program. Now we don't want to replace it. Okay, so that is our first library that we actually saw. So right now, let us close this and let us try out with a different library. So there is a library called random. So import random. What this library would basically allow us to do is to pick a random number, random integer value. So let us combine this library with the for loop that we covered before. So for I in range to 5, so we want to specify from that I goes from 1 to 5, we want to print, for example, random dot rand integer, which means that we are using from the random library a function called randint, which will basically just pick a random integer from the numbers between 1 and 100, for example. So we can specify it like this. If I just press here enter, you can see that this function right here, or not function, this for loop right here, will print out 5 random numbers that are in the range from 1 to 100. This for i in range 5 basically means that we are going to print 5 numbers, and this print random integer basically prints random numbers, which basically does it 5 times because we are in a for loop. So that is another example of actual library that we can use. Let us also check the output of our command prompt commands using the subprocess library. So import subprocess. Now, of course, if you're not familiar with any of this and you're actually confused while listening to me talking about this, don't worry. We're going to cover all of this in greater detail. Right now, I'm only showing you examples of importing different libraries and using their functions. So there is a function in the subprocess library called checkOutput, which allows us to check the actual output of a certain command being executed from our PC. So for example, if you go to the command prompt, open up your command prompt and type dir, you can see that it actually lists all the files in that current directory, which is this directory right here. So these are all the files in that current directory. What we want to do is we want to get that same output just with our Python. So in order to do that, we can just type here output will be equal to subprocess.check underscore output, which is a function that we will use from the subprocess library, open and close brackets, and in between the single quotes right here, you need to specify the command that you want to execute, which in our case, since we are on Windows, we want to execute dir. If you're on Linux, make sure to execute ls, because ls lists all the files in the current directory on Linux. Now, after it, we need to specify shell equals true, and that is basically it. If you just type here enter, it will execute this, and if we print the output, it will print it rather in a different format, but it will still print the current directory from this program. Now you can also do something else. search, for example, you can execute a different command. So let me just do the same thing. We can use cd command. So output will be equal right now to subprocess dot check underscore output. We want to execute cd, and cd basically in Windows will print you the current working directory that you are located in. And the in the Linux, if you're using Linux, just type here pwd, which stands for print working directory. Again, shell equals true. And we want to print the output in order to see in which directory is our program. We can see we are currently in the desktop directory, which is true. And right now, subprocess also allows us to, for example, execute different things. So we can actually create a file with this actual program right here, I believe. So let me just check it out. Subprocess.popen, or not popen, we want to use the, we can use popen, I believe. Let me just check out. Or we might actually get the actual access denied as before, but let us just give it a try. It doesn't even matter. Shell equals true. In this window right here, you can see all the things that you can specify for this function, which we really won't specify right now. We don't really care about them at the moment. So let us click here, enter. And we successfully did create the test directory. I'm not really sure if it was here. Yeah, it probably wasn't here, but doesn't even matter. We successfully created a file test on our desktop. Now, this is not the proper way to actually create files. I will show you later on, once we get to the file section, how you can create, manipulate, write, and read from the files. But for now on, that would be about it for this tutorial. Hope you enjoyed this little demonstration of importing different libraries. And I hope I see you in the next tutorial, where we will continue coding. So hope you enjoyed it, and I hope I see you in the next lecture. Bye!